Hello folks, my name is David Edgar, I'm the host of Heart and Hand, the Rangers podcast, and I'm joining you tonight after Rangers' dismal 1-0 home defeat to Aberdeen. If you saw the League Cup semi-final video from last month, then you don't need to watch this because it's basically just that redux. Rangers were garbage, really can't defend them. Usually I'll pick out a positive. If you watch these videos, you'll know I'm struggling tonight. I didn't see what it was. I don't really understand the team selection. I don't understand why Andy Halliday didn't play. You need to rotate players, I get that, but not every game. Do we need to change the full-back every game? I don't get that. We never change the right-back, so why the left-back has to change, I don't know. John Flanagan's not in good form. I don't know if he has been since he arrived at the club, in all honesty. And our midfield, I think there are questions about at the moment. We don't have anyone who can drive us on. Ryan Jack doesn't do it. He takes the ball from the defenders and he plays square balls. That's what he does. He's very neat and tidy, but he's got, you know, no drive, and he's not going to power you on at home. Ovi Ajaria has started the season well, but he's really gone off the boil. He's not doing much. And Lissana Koulibaly is the exact same. Since his injury, he's been very poor. And tonight, without Scott Arfield there, the midfield was ineffective. But that said, nobody played well. I genuinely can't. I mean, Alan McGregor I'd exempt because he'd none to do. Bar picked the ball at the net once. And the rest of the side, our passing was bad. The ball was allowed by Aberdeen to... They didn't press when Goldson, McCauley or Jack had it because they knew that they couldn't hurt us. We didn't move it quickly enough. I thought we'd come out the traps really quickly tonight. Boyd after a great win on Sunday. And we didn't, and then Aberdeen got a goal, a set-piece goal. It can happen. They've got some big guys in the team. Good finish from one of them, getting on the end of a loose ball. And that can happen. It's how you respond. And on Sunday, Rangers responded magnificently. Tonight, no. We could still be playing and we wouldn't have scored tonight. It was that type of performance. Two sending-offs, one for Aberdeen, which, again, should have ignited us. Stonewall, red card, incidentally. That big cart horse that they have up front, I don't know the boy's name, but I hope that he's won a competition or something to be a footballer, because if not, there's hope for all of us yet. But he gets himself sent off, and you think, OK, here we go. Nope, still just couldn't do it. Aberdeen, all they had to do was keep their discipline. They didn't have to be good, they just had to keep their discipline, and that was enough. We were not up to it tonight. And in the second half, Alfredo Morelos gets sent off. The first one is a joke. He gets booked because he's Alfredo Morelos, and that is piss poor. He is being refereed to a different standard. However, with all that said, the second one, what's he doing? I mean, that's just rank indiscipline, and I think that the manager has every right to go through him. So yeah, it was just terrible. Rangers, you know, played on, never really looked like scoring. And I think we know that this team is going to be inconsistent because it's, you know, assembled in one window. It's going to take time to develop. It still doesn't make it any easier when you get a night like that after the highs of Sunday and you're looking about the team and they were just devoid of everything you need tonight to be successful. So a window's coming up. We're going to need to go into it and bring in a couple of quality players to bolster us. As I say, I think we should be looking out at the midfielders we have who don't get a game, and I include Andy Halliday in that if Barisic is now fit. I include Greg Docherty if he can be brought back, but I also include guys like Rossiter, who's fit enough to make the bench, so get him in the team, and Ross McCrory, who I think offers you that bit more drive than somebody like Ryan Jack, because I think that the guys that we have in the midfield, maybe it's a combination. Maybe, you know, there are certain games where Ryan Jack's been brilliant, for example, and there were certain games early in the season where Ajaria and Koulibaly were good, but they're not playing well at the moment, so mix it up a little. But I'm clutching at straws a wee bit here. It was just terrible. And yeah, I think a bad night for the management and a bad night for the players meant a bad night for the fans. So yeah, right, I'm away to have a cocoa and hope it knocks me out and I can sleep. But I dare say I'll be replaying this game over and over in my head, and that will not be a particularly fun experience. But anyway, I hope you have a good night. I know you won't, but I hope you have a decent morning at least tomorrow, and I'll talk to you again after we play Dundee at the weekend. Till then, take care. Bye.